Hello there.
Hello, Julian.
Hello.
Welcome to StarTest, the computer interview.
You're too kind.
It's just the two of us here. But viewers will be phoning in during the show to vote on whether or not you are telling the truth. If they believe you, there will be the chance to play a clip from your latest video. If not, a mystery forfeit will appear in its place. So please, try to answer my questions honestly. Here are 9 categories of questions. Please select a category by simply touching the screen.
Sweet and sour, to start with.
Please choose any number.
Number 2.
What's the one thing that you don't have in your life that you would really like?
A girlfriend. Number 8.
Are you a slave to fashion?
No, I'm not. I can't be doing with fashion, as in the latest fashion. I put a lot of my energy into stage clothes. And so after that, my day wear is all a bit of an anticlimax. And you need to be quite organised and coordinated to sort out a stunning outfit to wear first thing in the morning. Usually it's some scrunched up t-shirt that hasn't been ironed, I'm sorry to say. Number 6.
Who is your best friend?
I've got lots of very good friends. I don't know if I have a best friend in the same sense that you have a best pair of shoes or you had a best friend when you were at school. I'll plump for Fanny the Wonder Dog, number 5.
Who would you choose as your sugar daddy?
Oh, what a nasty thought. That's some person that gives you money in return for sexual favours, and I'll have no doings with that, thank you very much. Number 13.
Why won't you tell the press what dog food Fanny eats?
Well, I haven't noticed them pounding on my door asking what dog food she eats. She's a vegetarian, of course, so she eats, I'll tell you now, she eats Wilson's mix. It's sort of oats and things, and you put hot water on it. And she's never complained, although I do feel, I think it's a shame that dogs, they can't just go to the fridge and open it and eat something when they're hungry. They have to wait until some kind human gives them something to eat. So I have to make these decisions on her behalf. But because she has a very sensitive bowel, we tend to stick to the oats. Number 11.
When were you last in a bad mood?
Yes, the day before yesterday, when I met... Well, I met Jonathan Ross, actually, and he upset me. Didn't mean to, of course. He was just talking about my television show and saying how vulgar it's become. And I'd had a bad day anyway, and so anything was likely to send me on the turn. And so I was a bit peeved about that. Because I like vulgarity, and I think the public does too. Have you seen the lovely Hugh Jelly anywhere?
Is he over there? Ah, here he comes now. Welcome. Welcome to Australia.
Thank you, sir.
How are you, Hugh?
Very well indeed, sir, thank you.
Are you having a nice time in Australia?
Yes, I've been surfing.
Surfing?
Yes, they bought me an extra wide board.
Hope you didn't get any foam in your mouth.
Before and after, please.
Please choose any number.
Number 3.
What regrets do you have in life?
I'd never met the person this was modelled on. Number 1.
How much of a kid are you?
How much of a kid?
How much of a kid are you?
As in child? How much of a child am I? I presume that's what you mean. I've got quite an overdeveloped child ego. Most people have three egos, parent, adult and child, and tend to spend most time in one ego state or another. So, because of my profession, I need to get into my child ego state. I hope that answers your inquiry. Number 14.
How proud are you of your background?
Well, I think it was a very pleasant background. You could do a lot worse. Tree-lined suburbia in Teddington. Bicycle rides through Bushy Park. So, yes, it was quite a nice background to have. Number 12.
How would you describe your favourite childhood toy?
My farmyard set. Well, lots of little plastic miniature animals. And it just so happened I had a green carpet in my bedroom, which was ideal for a farmyard setting. So I used to play with that more than any other toy, and I used to play with it on my own. It was Tom the gardener, the farmer, I should say, and his wife Jill, who had no legs because the dog bit them off. And they used to live in the pigsty for reasons best known to themselves. I had hours of fun with that, and I still have it in a cardboard box, which I get out from time to time when there's nothing on the telly. Number 15.
What were the darkest habits of the monks at school?
Well, I've no firm evidence. I've no photographic evidence, but there was one monk who was very elegant and used to swish around in his long black robes with the little hood at the back, which was quite nice. Sort of thing Big Fun would wear to a funeral, I always thought. And he'd waft around, flouncing around, and he'd sort of lurk outside the lower fourth latrines a lot. So what his habits were, I don't know. I'm sure they were entirely religious, but it raised an eyebrow or two amongst the lower sixth form. Number 10.
What was the best advice your parents ever gave you?
Do as you please. Number 11. This could do with the water.
What are your main concerns about growing old?
I don't mind growing old because it's inevitable and you get wiser as you grow older, so you get compensation for the loss of vitality that you suffer as you get older. But things like, I've got this pain in my elbow that I don't know what it is. It just sort of won't go away. And I think that's something to do with being a bit older, maybe. But no, I don't do anything with this arm to make it hurt. So aches and pains and ill health, I think, would be my answer. Number 7.
What would you like to have been if you'd had a different career?
A social worker, I think would suit me. Not because I'm particularly good at helping people with their problems, but because I'm interested in other people's lives, and I'm a gossip monger, basically, which is a sort of glorified social worker without the fringe benefits for the clients.
Please select a new category.
Faith and fortune.
Please choose any number.
Number 8.
Do you believe in a benevolent God?
Yes. Yeah, strikes me as pretty benevolent. He must be to have created Gary Bushell, I think. Number 12.
When did you last go to church?
You mean a good Catholic church, I presume. It would have been Christmas last year, I think. And jolly good it was too, a very good show. Number 11.
Do you enjoy gambling?
No. There's a theory going around the cabaret circuit that I spend all my spare time at the dogs betting on greyhounds, but I deny it all. Number 9.
What does your God look like?
He's got a great deal of makeup on, and his hair has been plaited. He's dressed in a lycra cycling outfit, and he's going cooey like that. Number one.
Who is your personal guru? Who is your personal guru?
There's a girl called Penny who does my rebirthing and body harmony and any kind of psychic sorting out that I need. And she's very good. She comes at a drop of a hat. Sometimes if I'm... I was at the Hackney Empire once, about to do a show, and I felt most peculiar. So I sent for Penny, and she came and did the laying on of hands in the dressing room and saved the day.
Now, please select a new category.
Certainly. Health and happiness.
Please choose any number.
Number one, please.
How do you keep your schoolboy complexion?
Well, I don't. It's just a lot of makeup. Underneath, it's a 31-year-old complexion. Number five.
How good a dancer are you?
I don't have the rhythm of life, sadly. I used to shake it around discotheques. And then I got to... I was going to sit on there, but I don't think I will. And I was all right, as long as you keep your legs, I found, if you keep your feet firmly on the ground and you just shake everything else around, you can get away with it if it's very busy and you stand in front of the smoke machine. But it's just not one of my talents. I'd like to have gone to dancing school when I was younger. Both my sisters did. But I was a boy, so I wasn't sent. And that's probably got something to do with it. Number six.
To what extent do you monitor your weight?
Well, there's a funny question. I never used to have to take any notice of it at all, but around about 28, 29, I don't know if your metabolism slows down or you just do too much shopping at Marks and Spencer's. And anyway, I started to get what's politely known as midriff bulge. And I'm holding it in now. But I do have to keep an eye on it, otherwise you can't wear lycra on stage. And although it's a comedy act and you're there to make people laugh, I don't really want people laughing at someone who's trying to fit into something that they can't. So it's a constant struggle, I can tell you. My manager bought me a rowing machine recently, which I use as a kind of objet d'art in the hallway, and I never considered mounting it for a moment. Number eight.
What do you sound like when you sing in the bath?
When I sing in the bath? Well, you're probably familiar with my singing. And it's much the same, a little bit more resonant in the bath because I've got a perspex shower screen, which makes it all nice and echoey. But the neighbours haven't complained.
Were you breastfed?
Yes, I was. But my mother didn't really enjoy it. But I was.
Do you prefer chocolates with hard or soft centres?
Hard, funnily enough.
Would you rather play a game of football or netball?
Oh, I'd rather be run over by a bus, I think.
What is your favourite cocktail?
A Brandy Alexander. I once had nine.
Would you rather eat 2 cloves of garlic or 6 spoons of cod liver oil?
I'd go for the cod liver oil.
What do you wear in bed?
A t-shirt.
Which is your favourite fruit?
Mango.
Which is your favourite band?
Band? Well, I don't know. You be 40. There. Well, we better get Love and Passion over with.
Please choose any number.
Yes. I get the idea now, I think. Number 5.
To what extent do you let your emotions show?
Not very much. Wouldn't wear my heart on my sleeve very much, and if I lose my temper, then I don't lose my temper. If I get angry, I can control it very well. I don't like being out of control, which is if you're crying hysterically or ranting at someone, you're not in control. So I try and avoid that in a very English sort of way. Keep tabs on things, but one does have a need to let off steam emotionally at times. So that's really where my rebirth and body harmony and things like that come into play. So I put time aside, and you go and do a bit of pillow punching therapy. That's more or less how I deal with that. Number 9.
Would you ever volunteer for one of Scylla's blind dates?
I'm a big fan of that programme. So I think I would, but they'd have to do a gay blind date, wouldn't they? Which I don't quite know that they're up to on Saturday primetime television on LWT. But should they do that, I'll be first in the queue. Number 12.
How would you rate yourself as a flirt?
Very good. Constantly flirting. I can't help myself. It's a Gemini trait as well. I think it's such fun flirting. Whether I'm any good or not, I don't know. But I do a lot of it, so it's bound to get better with practice. Number 10.
Which are your erogenous zones?
Oh, those are your fruity zones, aren't they? I think the groin area is a bit of a winner. The neck, the back of the neck as well. I certainly like looking at the backs of people's necks, if they've got one. Some people don't have a neck, really, to speak of. So the neck and there, and there's a certain area just around here that... It's one of those areas I can't stand being touched on that area. I feel very vulnerable around there. But I like it at the same time, if you know what I mean. I have to be forced. Number 13.
Is monogamy a problem?
No, it's not a problem. I quite like monogamy these days. I used to have no time for it. But I think in this day and age, you know, and what with being my age, I'm not that bothered with sleeping with everyone I see anymore. So I'm happily monogamous at the moment. And it's not a problem. If it was a problem, then I'd change the rules of the game, I think.
Now, please select a new category.
Right then. Is there anyone left? And that's honour and justice.
Please choose any number.
Number 8.
When did you last feel guilty?
Guilty? I think when I went out I'd only been out a couple of hours, but I came home and Fanny had been caught short in the bathroom which always makes you feel guilty because I should have been there to let her out. But she should have better bladder control as well. Number 13.
What have you ever stolen?
Oh, heaps. I used to, well, I still do. If I had a bad gig years ago, I'd steal something from the venue. It would cheer me up. Like, I've got a lovely mirror at home that came from Jongleurs in Battersea. I hope they've probably forgotten about it by now. Very nice. And I thought they hadn't paid me well enough or something nasty had happened to me. So I compensate myself for a rough deal by pocketing something. Number 11.
How good a liar are you?
Very good, very accomplished, very convincing liar. But I've given it up. It's the problem with lies is that you have to keep on with them, and you have to. I don't remember which lies I've said, and then one lie will lead to another lie, and before you know it, you're living in a fantasy world. So, it's much better to be brutally honest. Number 4.
Have you ever been arrested?
No, that's one of life's pleasures yet to come.
How do you feel at the end of the interview?
Well, I'm a little bit clammy under here. I feel a little bit clammy, but I'm looking forward to a nice cup of tea.
Who would you like to see in the star test chair?
Larry Grayson. Why don't you get him in? He could make it up the stairs. And Roger Whittaker. Joan Collins, she might come. If you promised her a burger. My assistant, Hugh Jelly, he'd be interesting as well.
You are now invited to select 5 characteristics from the on-screen menu, which you feel best illustrate your personality.
I can't see them very clearly. Fruity is a good word. I'd say I'd be fruity. Grubby. No, that's not one of them. Saucy. There you are. Fruity, saucy. Stubborn. Cheeky. And shy.
The phone poll results show that most viewers are happy you have been telling the truth.
Well, that just goes to show you how perceptive the British public are.
I was born under a wandering star. I was born.
I wish I hadn't started to slow down. Then I'm always saying that.
Wheels are made for rolling. Mules are made to pack. I never seen a sight that didn't look better looking back. I was born under a wandering star.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Here are 3 clues to my next mystery guest.
And if you want to know who this is, you need to tune in 15 minutes earlier next week at 11:45.